In this chapter, we're going to add spatial sound to our application. Spatial sound is sound that sounds like it's coming from an exact 3D point in the world around you. We're going to add two sounds to our app. One is some background music that will come from the origami collection, and the other is sounds that come from our sphere, impact and rolling sounds, to make them sound natural as they interact with the holograms and with the world. Minimize Visual Studio, close the Build Settings dialog, and now go back to the Holograms folder in the project pane. You can see there's an ambiance wave file. This represents the background music that we're going to add to our app. Go ahead and drag ambiance up into the origami collection. You can click on origami collection, and you'll now see an audio source has been created that represents that audio clip. The sound will now play, but we need to make it spatial, so it'll sound like it comes from this exact point in the world. To do this, we're going to check the box that says spatialize. We're going to make sure play on awake is checked so that the sound will play right away. And down where it says spatial blend, make sure you drag that all the way over to 3D. Finally, ensure that loop is checked so that the background music keeps on playing. You can also experiment with 3D sound settings below, such as setting the Doppler level to 0.1. Now that we have our background music, let's add impact and rolling sounds to our sphere. To do this, go to the scripts folder, right-click on Scripts, and say Create C# Script. Name this script Sphere Sounds. Make sure the origami collection is expanded, and drag Sphere Sounds onto Sphere 1 and onto Sphere 2. You can click on each object to make sure the script is attached. Go ahead and double-click on Sphere Sounds to open it up in Visual Studio, and then replace the contents with the contents from this chapter. In this script, we're going to initialize our audio source so that our impact and rolling sounds are ready to play. Then, based on the physics of that hologram, we're going to activate those sounds at the right moments of time. You can see in the start method that we're setting up the audio source, and we're setting up properties on it similar to the properties we set for the background music, including spatialize to make sure that it's 3D. We're then loading two clips, the impact clip and the rolling clip. Then, when this object collides with another object, onCollisionEnter is called. We're going to check the magnitude of that collision, and if it's strong enough, we're going to play that impact sound. As the object stays in collision with another object, we're going to get calls to onCollisionStay. And as long as the velocity is fast enough, we're going to keep that rolling sound playing. Once the rolling slows down enough, we're going to go ahead and stop the sound. We're also going to stop the sound if the object leaves collision with the other object, in case it fell off a table. Go ahead and save the script, minimize, and build and deploy as usual. You'll now hear impact sounds and rolling sounds as the spheres move around. When using spatial sound in the emulator, we recommend you use headphones to get the best 3D experience. In the next chapter, we're going to build on everything we've added so far and actually reason about the world around us using spatial mapping.